Hello, my name is Gregor Imrie and I'm the lead developer on the Solutions Intacct CIS module. The CIS module is an add-on which installs directly into the Intacct menus. It adds the ability to automatically calculate and apply CIS deductions when raising payments for subcontractors. It can then generate a CIS return based on the month's payments. It integrates with the government's CIS online service to allow verification of subcontractors and uploading of CIS returns. The ability to generate supply statements is planned in a future release. The module calculates the CIS deduction at the point of payment. It separates labour, materials and non-CIS amounts by looking at the GL accounts specified on the AP invoice lines. The invoice can be entered directly into AP, posted from the purchasing module, or imported from outside of Intacct. The source doesn't really matter. All that matters is that it hits AP and uses a single GL account for labour and a single GL account for materials. In the settings, I've got my labour and materials account set. You'll notice there is a retentions account setting. At present, there is no automatic calculation for retentions. It is just treated as a negative labour line in the CIS deduction calculations. The CIS control account is used during payment as the account that the CIS deduction transaction will be posted to. For a supplier to be picked up in the CIS screens, they must first be flagged as a subcontractor. The module adds a new CIS information tab against the supplier record, which contains this flag and a number of other settings. Most of these are used for verification and monthly return submission, but the tax treatment here is used to determine what percentage of labour is deducted. Gross is 0%, net is 20%, and higher is 30%. Over in my UK ops entity, I have an example invoice. Here we have £1,000 to the labour account and £500 to the CIS materials account. This supplier is set to net tax treatment, so there will be a £200 deduction from this invoice when we come to pay it. This labour line has a couple of tax lines making up the reverse charge posting. As these are entered when the invoice is raised and net off against each other, they have no impact on the payment or the CIS deduction. The creation of these reverse charge lines is not handled by the CIS module and should be handled by whatever module or process is used to create the invoice initially. Here we have the CIS payment screen. It is designed to mimic the standard payment process, so it should feel familiar to use. I'm just going to filter by global properties and apply that. And that's brought through our list of invoices to pay. We can navigate through this list using the controls at the bottom. We can also change the number of records we show. We've also got the export options down here. We can sort by any of these columns, and we can also sort by one column, hold shift and click additional columns to sort the data further. Some columns allow us to apply a filter. So here I've just filtered by that invoice we were looking at earlier. If a field is highlighted in blue, it means we can click it and either pop open another CIS screen, or in some cases, it'll open up a standard Intacct record in a new tab. So in this case, it's opened up the invoice record. All of the tables throughout the CIS module use this same table structure, so these same functions will apply to those as well. If I wanted to fully pay this invoice, I could tick the box here or drill into the invoice and fully pay individual lines. I can also specify an amount to pay. You'll notice the maximum amount I can pay on this line is £800. This is because the module has automatically subtracted the CIS deduction from the payment amount. Here it shows the amount due is 1,000. CIS deduction that will be applied is 200, and therefore the actual amount due to the supplier is £800. So if I pay 400 on this line, save that, you'll see in this little summary window we've got a payment amount of 400, and that's going to raise a deduction of £100. If I needed to apply a credit or recharge, I can do that in here. Credit notes, debit memos, and AP advances will show up in here. If your AP is not set to automatically apply inline credits, you'll see those here too. As I've clicked add credits on a labour invoice line, then applying a transaction that is coded to the labour account will be considered a credit. This will reduce the deductible amount on the line, so no deduction will be applied. So here I could apply a £500 credit. This will raise no deduction, and our remaining amount to pay is 400, which will just give us that £100 deduction. If a transaction is coded to a different account, then applying it to labour will be considered a recharge. This will not reduce the deductible amount and will result in a deduction being applied. So I can apply £400 here. Different accounts will be treated as a recharge. That's now fully paid this invoice line. And you'll see here we've got the credit from earlier. We've got a £400 recharge and 20%. We've got that £100 deduction. To keep things simple in this demonstration, I'm just going to fully pay the invoice. So that's 800 plus the deduction on labour, 500 on materials, and no credits. Pick my bank, and I'm going to pick cash again to keep things simple. Get a little summary screen. And that's now completed, creating one CIS deduction, which I'll show you in a moment, and one payment. In a larger payment run, which might involve multiple invoices, multiple suppliers, one payment will be created per supplier, and one deduction will be created per invoice. If I navigate back to the invoice now, we can see the invoice has been fully paid. We've got 800 and 500 to my cash payment, and then 200 to this AP adjustment for the CIS deduction. Going to AP adjustments. And we can see here we've got a £200 debit memo, and that's been coded to the CIS control account that we set in the CIS settings. Over in posted payments, we can see the payment, and then we can reprint the remittance. And here we've got the 1300 cash, our 200 deduction. The reference number for the deduction will mention the invoice it relates to. If I'd have paid this via bank file, or if I was using purchase payment approvals, then I'd have needed to go through those processes first. The CIS module only replaces that initial step of picking the invoices to pay. As such, if I cancelled the payment request, or didn't authorise the payment, the deduction would not be automatically rolled back by Intacct. I can use the unallocated deductions screen to locate and delete any leftover deductions. With the deductions being applied at payment time, it isn't obvious from looking at AP reports what is actually due to be paid to suppliers. The outstanding balances screen can be used to see what is due to the supplier, assuming all CIS deductions were applied. So here we've got the balance as per AP, the CIS due, and the updated balance. We've got those per transaction as well, and we can drill in to view the individual lines if we need to. Suppliers can be verified with HMRC using the Verify Subcontractor screen. This will send across the details set in the CIS Information tab to HMRC to check they are registered, and will return their verification number and tax treatment if they are. In a later version, you'll be able to edit the CIS information fields directly within this screen. I'm connected to HMRC's test gateway, so it always matches to George Wilkinson. Once I've finished my payments for the period, I can generate a monthly return from the monthly return screen. Period ending 5th of December. And this has pulled through and added up all my transactions for any supplier marked as a subcontractor. I can drill into individual amounts or individual suppliers to see the transactions that make up these figures, or I can view all transactions. I'm just going to filter this on the invoice we were looking at before. So I can drill into these to see the invoice. Or this is the deduction transaction, so I can link back to the AP adjustment, and then on the payment lines I can see the posted payment. If I needed to make a manual adjustment to these figures, I can from here. Got that adjustment, and that's now changed the deducted amount on this supplier. If I needed to cancel this return for any reason, I can do that here. Or if an additional payment had been posted and I needed to fetch the latest transactions, I could click Recreate. This will cancel this return and copy any manual adjustments over to the newly created return. Cancelled returns are stored so they can be referred back to at a later date. So here I've got my cancelled return. If I want to submit this return to HMRC, I've got the submit button here. This will just give you a summary of what's going to be sent. And that's been submitted successfully. At this point, I can still make adjustments to this return and resubmit to HMRC. When I'm ready to finalize the return, I can click Complete. This will lock the return so it can't be adjusted, cancelled, or recreated. If the return was not submitted to HMRC before completion, it will be marked as submission not required. That concludes this demonstration of the Solutions Intacct CIS module. Thank you for watching and have a great day.